Okay, keep your hands up and everyone look around. This is our goal for students globally. So, according to UNICEF, 1/5 of homicide victims globally are children and adolescents under the age of 20, resulting in about 95,000 homicide deaths that were reported among this age group in 2012 alone. RT News reported that UNICEF stated Nigeria has the largest number of children's deaths, totaling 13,000 in 2012, and that Israel was second with 11,000 deaths. So, when I learned about this problem, I immediately wanted to help, and I had to think about, okay, what do I know, what am I good at that I can help and implement into Nigeria to help these kids and lower the homicide rate? So, being an art education law student major, I have extensive background knowledge and experience in both art and education. So, it seemed like the ideal solution to integrate these two into something in Nigeria, and that would be an after-school art program. So, in an after-school art program, students would be provided with nutritional snacks and meals. Oftentimes, students are not provided with the nutrition that they need to succeed in school, whether it be a financial problem or they just don't have access to it. So, with this, they would be provided a nutritional meal after school to help fuel their bodies, stimulate their brains, and just help promote a healthier lifestyle for them. Second, students will be provided with a safe environment. So the youth crime rate in Nigeria is rather high, and so to have a place for children to go after school hours where if they go home, they are quite possibly unsupervised, their parents would be at work, or they're just not around. So this gives opportunities to go out into the streets unsupervised and get into all kinds of trouble, whether it be sex, drugs, rock and roll, or gangs or whatever. So, with a safe place for students to go where they're supervised, and then it would also be a learning environment for them, this would benefit students in the long run and hopefully help lower the crime rates and homicide rates for children. Oops, I lied. Historical and cultural information. So, students would have the opportunity to create projects that could be based off of something from a specific culture that's of importance. So, a student would be taught in a classroom maybe a certain tradition that a specific culture has that incorporates art. So the students would then be guided in instruction and learning from that. They would then have the opportunity to research it on their own, which is individual learning, and then they take that, what they learned, and then be able to apply it into an art project. So this would help visual learners because they'd be able to see it, auditory learners because they could hear it, and then tactile learners because then they get to take the information that they learned and apply it into an art project. Historical information as well. Students could be shown pieces of work from a famous artists, either locally or historically, nationally, whatever. And then they would be able, again, to learn this in a guided environment, then individually, and then they could take this stuff that they learned and put it into their works. Then last but not least, they would be provided with creative skills and problem solving. So these are valuable life skills, and these two valuable life skills that I really emphasize are critical thinking and creative problem solving. So critical thinking is important in all aspects of life. If you don't have critical thinking, you can't make good choices. So these would help them, for the students within the program, learn these critical thinking skills through making art, and they'd be able to translate this over into other areas of life. Youth unemployment rate and poverty rate are also very high in Nigeria. So if they have these skills, that they have learned and they're able to apply them into other areas of life, it makes them more marketable to get jobs and make better life decisions. It also teach them creative problem solving. In art, a lot of times things don't turn out the way you want them or you mess up and there's no way to undo your mistake. You have to figure out how to fix it in another way. Maybe you don't have the resources you need and you have to just completely change everything. But but you still need to get that outcome that you originally wanted. So you have to take these problem-solving skills and figure out, okay, what am I going to do? So then if they have these skills in art, they could then also translate this skill into their life and be able to, again, be more marketable for jobs and help themselves in their life in the long run. They'd also learn positive trade skills because art's all around us, whether it be painting, sculptures, graphic design, or jewelry making. They've learned these skills within this program. They'd be able to implement them later on in life. So the options for this, ideally it would be set up in schools and assisted by the teachers that these students have every day. This would help ensure a safe environment for these students because they know their teachers and the teachers know them. It would also be able to help me in the long run because if these teachers know about these students, they can help them want to come to this program. It would help them gauge their ability and learning and what they need to in order to understand what we're talking about and to follow the projects. The second option would be to have a staff that would be composed of highly qualified individuals, which would include licensed teachers, registered nurses, licensed psychologists, psychiatrists, and then professional artists. But this would cost a lot of money to pay these people to be over here. So that would be great because it would teach the students a lot, and it would help them lead the healthiest lifestyle possible. But, you know, the numbers just, they're not good. So then there's a third option where it would be run by volunteers from the community. This would be great because it would lower the funding for it. However, these people could just be random volunteers off the streets who pass this training process. They may not know anything about art or anything about education, and so it wouldn't help the students in the long run. And the students may not feel comfortable with these volunteers. So overall, I just would request funding for this project to help these students get out of the streets and into a safe environment where they would be fed a nutritious meal, taught skills that they need later on in life, and be able to learn about other cultures and historical things that they need.